everyone, I'm Tasha. First of all, I want to thank the organizers of RECON for the invitation. Since the beginning of the global lockdown and quarantine in 2020, we have gone crazy about the quantity of ideas we had, but we were unable to fully implement. Then we decided to create an online project. This is how Project Avatar has born. I'm going to talk about this experience today. I'll tell you about our grounding in creating games, scenarios, escape rooms, parallel realities. But I'll take you to this journey not as a co-owner of the production, but as a creator, artist, magician, because these are exactly who we are. We started out simple with no experience, but with an idea. And when we started to create an online product, we found ourselves in the same circumstances. We were back to square one. It was the beginning of the creation of new gaming sphere, online games with Avatar. There is no opportunity for the creators to play the game they produce, experience the emotions that players experience when they get into the escape room. But this is a price to pay for another type of game. We start playing it at the very moment when we decide to build a room, create a game. Fortunately, we have a little more than 1 hour for this game, otherwise I would go on crazy. Have you ever heard about 5 stages of grief? When I started writing my speech, I suddenly realized that there are 5 stages of creating a quest or game scenario. But keep in mind that I'm talking about creating a good game, not about banal room with a set of riddles. Sometimes good riddles, sometimes stolen ideas, but I'm not talking about that. I would like to remind you of the stage of grief: denial, anger, bargaining, depression, acceptance. Projected on creation of the game scenario, the stages are not so sad but very similar. I think that those who build escape room will recognize themselves, and amateur enthusiasts will understand that creators put their heart and soul into their creations. I promise you, I'm not to be boring. Moreover, I will describe each stage by the case of creating Project Avatar games. The first stage of creator games is called I have a great idea. At this stage, you go crazy and try to convey to everyone your genius idea. You have butterflies in your stomach, you have a head in the clouds. At this stage, it seems that you can put into practice any idea, that you can create everything. And I sympathize you if your partner, just like mine, is your loved one, and you are like-minded people. Then together, you plunk into the world of ideological illusion and swim in the chocolate rivers at the Willy Wonka's factory. Usually, this stage comes at a time of aggravation, when you watched some great movie or just left a very cool escape room. Sometimes such aggravation can happen when you enter a flea market and find some very beautiful objects and artifacts. And then here come to mind, open the door without even knocking and take up all the space. From now on, you are unable to think about anything else until you put this idea on a paper. At this stage, you have to plunk into the world of this idea, have to become a part of what you invented, and certainly discuss it with all your friends. Everyone who could make time to listen to you, give a view and suggest addition. Because if someone gets very excited about your idea, they get into your fictional world and can supplement it with something interesting. And so it's very important to choose the right associates, someone you trust. Otherwise, you can run into those who will destroy your dream, destroy your idea into dicks. My advice to you as a creative person: do not listen to those who are unable to support you in your endeavors. Do not listen to those who cannot feel full the joy and spirit. In Italy, you have to establish a concept instead of testing the idea for strength.
A small life hack for those who write game scripts. There are many useful programs where you can build a chain of riddles and their correlation. We are using Miro.
Here you can find Miro service.
In free version, you can only create one board, but for a little money you get more options. Let's check what we can do. These tools are available in free version. Here's many templates available for us. Let's take one of them as an example. You can write on the stickers, move them, and also connect them with arrows. Everything is very intuitive. Selected items can be moved or deleted. It's very convenient to use icons. There are a lot of them on any topic. Therefore, you can find what you need to create your script logic. You can draw on your board. You can import any pictures. You can create a chain of riddles according to your script and understand where the logic of actions fails. Besides, you may find out whether the script is linear or not, and whether the quantity of players is calculated correctly, so that all players will have something to do. This is perfect tool for any quest game creation. Let me give you one more thing. If you create an in-person offline escape room, then on average you need 13-15 riddles for a team of up to 7 people. That's enough to keep them busy for an hour. But of course, be reasonable and keep in mind that you also have to take into account the complexity of riddles. Feel free to use all instruments that game designers and script writers use. These instruments are for you as well.
The second stage is called feasibility check. At this stage, you have to check if your ideas can be implemented to practice or not, and if the objects fit into the reality you invented. You should have a seat and describe not only the idea, but also the entry chain of actions, elements, items that will be needed. It is important to create a player path. In fact, you have to imagine a player, or rather several players, and imagine yourself walking with them around the room. Mirror app or any analog for building quest sequence will help you with this. And when your script is written, ask yourself if you have enough capacity, budget, experience to implement it. And when writing your script, it is also important to understand that everything inside the game must correspond to the world that you create, correspond to that reality. I mean, you shouldn't use the safe with a mass market key part if your game is about Middle Ages. But also, do not forget that you will implementing this game in an ordinary reality, where the laws of physics and money apply. Unfortunately, if you want to unicorns fly and illuminate the path of the players with a rainbow in your perfect game, you have to pay extra. This applies to any type of game, not only escape rooms. In our common reality, one rule applies. Either you can do it yourself or get ready to pay someone who can. Well, either don't do it at all. I'll tell you honestly, I have played many games, many escape rooms. There were very expensive ones there that were breathtaking. And there were reasonably priced ones, but breathtaking as well. All the rooms that I had left delight had a good scenario tested for reality. If you realize that your budget is low, do not try to build a space shuttle. Choose those stamps, items for which you can find in the flea market at cost for a few dollars. The furniture can be found on the ads free of charge. Take your time to come up with a story with logical suspense of actions, with unusual riddles. Sometimes the most interesting riddles do not require extraordinary knowledge of electronics. Sometimes you just have to use ordinary object in an unusual way to create an interesting riddle. Another piece of advice that I will give you is to see the world through the eyes of a child, but with an experience of adult. Indeed, in childhood, we explored all possible opinions and tested this world for strength. When you work on your game, on your props, do not stop fantasizing. And then perhaps your floor lamp will turn into a real dragon. My personal life hack is to use one more app. This is app instant for writers, but in fact, it can be for any project. There you can streamline your thoughts, work process and more. This app called Scrivener.
On this webpage, you can get your Scrivener. This is a paid program, but it's not expensive at all. It's available for macOS, Windows, iOS or both of them. It's nice that there is 30-day trial period, and it's 30 days of use. If you use it every day, it lasts 30 days. If you use it only 2 days a week, it lasts 15 weeks. Once launched, you will see many project templates for all occasions. Let's start with a novel template. Start by creating a piggy bank of inspiration for yourself in this app. Create millions of folders with ideas on various topics. Write down all your ideas here. If you see a cool movie scene and realize how it can be turned into a riddle, for example, write down the movie, the time code, and the essential message. Or just add the link to ideas in the folder you need by topic. This will keep your ideas at your fingertips. If you find some cool picture and you think it would be cool to make such a decoration, then save the picture here in an appropriate folder. In the same file, you can add a link to the video. Add a small preview image to your design file. Add a script file to the folder. Alternatively, import a ready-made script from any text file. This may take a few minutes. Don't forget about synopsis in your scripts. We will return to it a little later. The text is imported in full. All links are active. Let's go back to the synopsis. Copy the synopsis from the script to the preview of idea folder. You'll then be able to see a short description of your idea in your piggy bank. If you find a video with a mechanism that you want to use or some new technology that you want to implement in your new game, then save it here. Be sure to make notes so that you can understand where to use it later. If you don't have a synopsis for your game yet, just write a few words about the idea in general. And believe me, when you work on your new project, you definitely thank yourself for this piggy bank of inspiration.
The third stage is called creating a masterpiece. In Italy, I call it hell mixer. But after listening to my speech, my friend said it was too much. Although I think most creators may say that the initial name is closer to reality. At this stage, we are looking for everything and everyone we require. Even when we come to visit our parents, we climb into their attic looking for treasures, looking for my treasures. And in response to my mother's question, how are you, we just mumble nonsense and ask if she additionally have an extra garden hose and two gnomes. She was shocked. Sometimes, by the way, we got a pie from my mother for this, because we were tired and we needed to be treated. By the way, I want a pie. I'm gonna ask my mom about the gnome. searching for the right items take us to the most amazing places. Flea markets, thrift stores, garage sales, and many other places where adequate people usually do not go. The most interesting thing is that even we have a list of necessary purchases, for some reason we often find something very beautiful, but might be useful somehow later. And these things come in handy sometimes in a year, sometimes in 5 years. But these things find their place, don't they? Shopping is not our only entertainment. It should be remembered how much effort it takes to find a premise. The stars should align, turn first to Jupiter, then to Mars. Do you think I'm exaggerating? Not at all. Finding a premise as well as collecting the old documents and permits is a hell. Sometimes it seems to me that it's what Dante wrote about it in a Divine Comedy. Maybe he was the first to open an escape room, but apparently failed to do that. And finally, selection of contractors. I'm just wondering if many electricians did power wiring for several riddles on one line, just like sockets. We discovered this surprise while testing the room, when everything was ready and connected. And we just solved it, a riddle, when a half of room remained without power, all locks opened. We spent several hours until we realized that this was not a short circuit. At first we were delighted, but then we realized it, that we had to redo the wires, which are in the walls, which are painted and decorated. Honestly, I don't know how Leonardo da Vinci painted Mona Lisa, but to build a room to create a game is comparable to creating a masterpiece. The fourth stage I called show your drawing not only to your mother. This is the most terrible and painful stage for every creator, since you have to introduce to the world your favorite masterpiece, your creation. Get ready to be criticized, especially if you're doing something extraordinary, something unique, something without ready-made hem, something not taught in universities. The skills necessary to create escape rooms are acquired mainly through personal experience. Therefore, at first we are like children who draw a circle with a few lines and believe we have drawn sun. We show our painting to mom, and of course mom says that the sun is beautiful. But since we are not creating escape rooms for moms, we have to go through this painful stage and modify, correct and improve creations. At this stage, it is important to take into account the opinion of all players to create a high quality product. Eventually we learn, gain experience and start understanding how to do everything right from the very beginning. But the sky is the limit. We'll always improve our games, our escape rooms. Therefore, it is important to learn to accept criticism. This is what the testing period for. When everything is built, everything works as we plan it, but we can never predict how the player will behave. Of course, you can cover the whole room with the stop stickers or limit the players by establishing the rules, but in this case, everything loses its realism. Do not be afraid of criticism. Do not be afraid to listen to the players. There is no need to prove them that they misunderstood you. Just explain to them what effect you wanted to achieve and ask what should be done to make it clear. What was the most difficult? What can be improved? People testing your rooms are not your enemies. They are your tool. Of course, you will notice what is wrong and what does not work well during testing, but you can never see the game from inside as your tester teams will. Invite at least 15-20 teams for testing and do not limit them in time. Make time for them after the game as well. It should be important for you to listen to each player, even if you disagree with their opinion. Listen to them and find out why they have such an opinion. And after that, you can go through the last circle of hell and modify, improve your masterpiece. Only then you will not be ashamed to present it to the whole world. The five stage is the most pleasant one, and it's called the essence of accomplishment. When we correct all the mistakes and pass the last circle of hell, we are consumed with a sense of accomplishment. Of course, you got jitters before the first paid games. When the test teams play, you are not afraid that something may go wrong, as the players know in advance that the product is not completely ready and forgive you for the shortcomings. But when the first clients play, that's when the hair sinks into your boots and your hands shake. Of course, it increases your chance to make a mistake, but still, it's a pleasant part of the game called the creator. Every time you have the games and see the emotions of players, you experience the same emotions, and all your efforts, suffering and nervousness are paid off when you see the happy faces of people, when you listen to their feedback in the end, and you realize that everything worth it. Of course, this is a business, and a business is run to make money. But this is not a kind of business to make money only. This is a business of emotions. Everyone who somehow relates to creativity and creation of something unusual wants recognition. It is important for every artist that his painting is seen and enjoyed. So it's important for all of us that people play and experience the emotions provided by creating more and more new games. And then we can enjoy the result of our work, the result of our fantasy tears and worryings. Of course, after all these, there are still many stages such as tales, staff training and so on, but they are about a very little creativity and not fun at all. And since I managed a maximum fun in the title of my speech, I would not talk about that things, because nine more circles of hell await us there. As I promised it, a living example. I'm going to tell you in detail about how the idea of the avatar remote control made us look at everything much more broadly. About how you can create something innovative by connecting several competing business niches. The very idea to combine a video game and escape room came to my partner Seva a long time ago. It got in our heads and waited for better times. It was going forth and back, each time crashing on reality. So it had been wandering in our mind since 2016, and time after time we were stopped by different reasons. A lack of light equipment for the avatar, problems with the live stream, realizing that it would be very difficult to sit people down to the computer. We were passionate about this idea and constantly discussed it with all our friends. And they had been so taken by the idea that we had started to discuss only this topic soon. Since we already had a lot of experience in creating escape rooms, it was little either for us. But we had no idea what lay ahead. First of all, having formed a general idea, we realized that it would take a lot of effort to implement it. But desire conquered all fears and made many impossible things possible. Our friends supported us, and I'm sure that without their help, we would not have achieved such a result. In the beginning, we decided to collect everything that can be used for the game. We collect different items from our garage, attics, from production warehouse, and began to build a game chain. For these items to build a first game, we should have figured out wherever everything would work as we imagined it in our head. The first question was the premises. The game should be placed somewhere. The avatar should run somewhere. And we decided that there are no better place than abandoned premises. After all, what could be more interesting than abandoned premises? The decision gave us opportunity to integrate innovation into the gameplay mechanics. If the premises are not new, it can be destroyed a little, isn't it? Therefore, we added to the script some things that cannot be done in ordinary escape room. We gave players the ability to smash and knock down the doors. In addition, the presence of avatar in a protective jar gives a guarantee of safety. Players cannot accidentally injure themselves through the screen, but they can experience emotions from the POV videos. At first, there was a fear that players would destroy everything around them and we would spend everything we earn on restoring the equipment. But it turned out that when you can, you don't really want to. Basically, the players experienced the maximum emotions of destroying in the first room, smashing several jars, overturning cabinets, and then having enjoyed the crashes, they forgot about it. Well, of course, except these cases when it was necessary to kick out the door or use a screw bar according to the script. Nobody wanted to break the beautiful game props. Still, people have a sense of beauty. So, having explored a lot of available abandoned premises, we selected one of them. By the way, we are now here at this place. This is where we start.
We completely made up the world, the main character, the alternate reality, and the rules in this reality. All the props were ready, including an artificial corpse. We even drew a plan of the premises for convenience. Please note that it was abandoned wine factory. We decided to test this game out on our friends. Some of our friends helped to prepare the location for tests, and others were waiting for the first live stream. We chose Zoom among other services. It turned out to be the most suitable for our needs. The X-Day finally came. The team went to the location to place the props. The camera was installed on an old motorcycle helmet. The process has begun. And once our team had put all the props in their places, a police patrol car had arrived at the building. As it turned out, the building was in emergency condition, and we were not allowed to play there. You should have seen the faces of the policeman being told that we had laid out the game props. And in fact, there would be one person walking there in a hamlet with a camera, and people would control him. The icing on the cake was the moment when the guys carried the artificial corpse out of the building. But we did not give up so easily. And the team went to the second location, which seemed to suit us as well. But we were disappointed once again. Not by the police, but the lack of mobile internet. By the way, we went back to that winery once again, when we were filming the backstory for the first mission game. And we were met by the police again. But it turned out that the building was not really so dangerous for filming an art house movie, if you know what I mean. I'm not gonna bore you with the story of how we were looking for a legal way to occupy an abandoned premises. I just wanna say, if you believe in your idea and go the right way, then you meet the right people. So we meet a person who became an integral part of our project. I'm not sure what made Dmitry believe in our project so much, but he's still an integral part of the project. He not only solved our issue with premises, as we became the first residents of Lamp Station even before their official opening, but thanks to him, there are the video content in our game. He actually forced us to deal with the OBS program. This program is another innovation that made our game what it is. We created a game that test teams like it, that brought pleasant emotion to player, but still something was missing, and the missing element was the video. But Zoom was not enough to add the video stories, and exactly OBS gave us the opportunity to transform the game into a live movie. We have added movie production to the process of creating game and a live broadcast at the level of TV show to the mechanics of the game. Smooth transition between movie scenes and online stream makes the gaming experience unforgettable. Anyone who played our games may have noticed the HUD as in a video game. With its help, player can follow the process of the game without using additional sources. Adding an information panel to the structure of the game helped us to solve one of the main problems. We didn't want players to record a lot or switch tabs to see game inventory. We wanted players to always stay on the same tab in the Zoom program or in the browser version, so that they just enjoy the game without being distracted by unnecessary action that threw them out from the atmosphere that we create. Thanks to the video integration, we were able to make our players feel like you feel entering a well-made escape room. We transferred the players to our location through the monitor, and any distraction from the game process could break the thin thread of connection between the reality we created and our players. We changed the HUD depending on the needs of the scenario line, thus our players can check what items they have and what can be used at any time. In fact, we have provided the convenience of a video game with the additional software. Avatar also played an important role. He still played. Our silent actor with a great sense of humor becomes one with the team of players. He always detects the mood of the team and knows how to soundly offer a player a clue when they reach a deadlock. Players can only see his hands, but they fall in love with his character, enjoying him freaks and freaks alone with him. Our players have helped us to build and create the game so far. Thanks to test players who made time to our project at the beginning of journey, our games were able to win awards in 2020. Testing was the most terrible stage for us, since we have been creating the first game for 3 months and did not know how the players would react to it. After all, it was something new and unknown. We did not use ready-made patterns. We added several competing types of entertainment into one bottle and mixed it well. In addition, we were so busy to creating our game that we have no idea what was happening on the market. We saw a ton of posts about new games and saw a lot of good reviews, but we played the first online game in December of 2020. We listened very carefully to all players' advice. And we are still listening. We take into account all the tips on what can be improved. Probably that's why we have 99% of positive reviews. And here is the last stage when we can enjoy the emotions of our players. Of course, during the game, fuck-ups may happen, and we are solving these problems on live stream. Our players do not notice this. It's all about improvisations, you know? Later we love this situation, but it's later. For example, recently, after reinstalling the program on a computer, we installed all game scenes on it, while the game was compliant for the new ones. But thanks to the team's ingenuity and Avatar's nerves of steel, everything went smoothly. For the players. But after such incidents, we realize that we are able to solve any problem and nothing may affect the overall impression of our players. You know, we often host the game together with our team. Though player the game, you may find yourself in the creator hands. You know, it's a pleasure for us. Personally, it's really charging. This wall of emotions can hardly be experienced somewhere else.
And now you can enjoy this game because we created it for you. Thank you all for your attention. I hope that my speech was interesting and inspiring for you and did not bore you. I will be happy to answer all your questions, and we will always be happy to help everyone along their way to create an in-game. And remember that in order to create a game that will bring incredible emotions, you have to play the game called Creator. And this is how we with Seva created our games. As fun as possible, so that players can have too much fun as well.